Oh, sorry, look, I can't stop. I'm late picking Si up from chess club.
Oh, okay, what time's he going to bed, honey? I just need to pick your brains.
I've got to get him to me dad's and I've got to get myself back and ready for tonight, so will it keep?
Yeah, of course it will.
All right, okay. Hey, text me in case I forget, yeah?
Jason!
74, though. Not a bad age to die, I suppose.
Try saying that to a 73-year-old.
What about you? I mean, you never talk about your folks. Is your dad still alive?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. You plant a nuclear bomb under the Tindley estate and that old codger will come crawling out the wreckage, gagging for a glug and run.
Warm and fulfilling relationship. Yeah. Oh, yeah, I know all about them. Did you see that? Now that is a pro.
She can break a stride.
Yeah, but I wonder what else we've told him apart from me being a raging alcoholic. Don't let him play with matches.
Well, what else is there to tell? I mean, the rest of us are saints, aren't we?
Ah, go on. Don't do it to yourself.
I love the way the bubbles dance over the rim, mate. You must be tempted sometimes.
Oh, yeah, every day. But I've got something to live for now, don't I? Look, excuse me. My fiancée's bored, she needs rescuing.
How do you know?
Right here, ring.
Oh, sorry,
I just want to know what works and what doesn't. Like 6 months from now, Paddy McGinn will be serving egg and chips and all these drinkers will be meatheads.
Well, I'll pass your comments on to the management.
Do. Your boss. He's a very important person. Funny he didn't invite your boyfriend.
A, Lloyd's not my boyfriend. And B, he's got a very important job of his own tonight. Looking after your son.
Oh! Ayo! It's the Taliban. You're not going to shut us down again, have you, Ken?
Finish,
honey.
I'm mine. I do apologise.
Oh,
mildly
missed.
Is that the best you can do? Hiya. Hello? No, sorry, I can't hear you. Hang on a minute. Hello? All right, look, just calm down and tell me what happened from the beginning. Okay?
How are you doing?
Week in, week out. If you don't mind me asking, still keep your figure.
And not just that, keep the opinions fresh. I mean, let's face it, half the time it must feel like saying a deal is a dump.
Half the time, more like 75%, but not tonight.
Oh, she had to say that.
No, I mean it. I've had a blast and it's only... Why is it? I passed 8 already. I'm not supposed to have carbs past 7. He's hearing all of that black pudding.
All right, look, all right, I'll be there as quick as I can. Yeah, I'm leaving now, okay? Excuse me, love. I'm looking for a pal of mine. There's been a bit of bother.
Bother? That's my middle name. I can walk. Not in a straight line, maybe. Right, you'll be hearing from my solicitor. Come on, let's get out of this dump.
Sorry, there's a footballer!
Oh, what? No hug? Don't tell me I'm in the naughty corner with you and all.
Drink driving? You were drinking orange juice. What happened?
Hook Street. They picked me up on Hook Street. Blasted Hook Street's yard from the flat.
How could you?
Oh, does it matter? It's been done. I've been done. Whichever way you look at it, it's a total disaster.
And Coronation.
Sir? You're missing your party.
Yeah, well, there'll be others.
And you won't be able to drink at any of them.
Now, there's a sobering thought.
Oh, you're a cunning little alky, but I like you.
And you sure it was just the 3 glasses that you had?
Yep, tragically. Oh, if you're going to get done for drink driving, at least go out in style. 3 glasses barely touch the sides.
Yeah, well, that's just as well. That's just as well because you could have killed somebody. You could have killed a kid.
I could have knocked down an old lady. Somebody might have loved her, or used her. I mean, kids, they rule the world.
I'm making you one of these Ponty Earl Greys. Leanne likes this stuff, you know?
Yeah.
Talk of the devil.
What happened? You were doing really well.
Yeah, well, I might spend the rest of my days totally out of my tree.
Did something happen tonight?
Yes. 3 glasses of Verve Clico, officer.
What is it? Why am I getting the feeling that you're angry with me?
Like I said, you're missing your party.
I think positive. You know, some people actively choose not to drive.
And do they own a factory or have breakfast meetings all over the north of England?
Okay. Hayley Cropper could be your designated driver.
What? Oh, look, stop trying to fix everything.
And you sit in the back, you plough through all your paperwork, which actually, pound for pound, is a much better use of your time, isn't it?
Yeah, maybe. I don't know.
Also, I reckon you'd suit that whole Lady Penelope thing.
Look, shouldn't you be getting back to the bar? I am fine. I'm really not going to go in search of the nearest bottle of Thunderbird.
You're far from fine, Carla. Tell me what happened. Please.
When I saw you at tea time, I was trying to send out a mayday.
Right. And I fobbed you off.
No, you were busy with your own life. You are entitled.
No, I should have tuned into you. I'm really sorry.
Oh, look, I don't want you to be sorry. I don't want to be something on your conscience.
Hey, you're not. You're a valued mate to me.
Oh, kill me now. Oh. Look, tonight I was trying to drown my sorrows. Well, just one big sorrow, actually. But it's a biggie.
Okay. Try me.
Oh. It's you, you big pillock. And don't... Please don't tell me this is a schoolgirl crush, because you're right under my skin, and I'm guessing by the look on your mush you didn't have the slightest inkling to cheat. God, I need a drink.
Right.
You're still here. I was hoping you'd legged it.
Look, Carla, I'm unbelievably flattered.
Yeah, I know, when you've got Leanne. And her liver's all lovely and tickly pink, and she don't drink and drive and throw herself at unavailable men, does she?
I'm in love with Leanne. And, hey, I don't mean that to sound
smart. Oh, it doesn't.
Otherwise, I bit your arm off.
Yeah. Enough said.
Your very smooth-toned arm. I have got eyes, you know. You're beyond gorgeous, you're off the scale.
Oh, hey-ho. At least that's the nicest rejection I've ever had.
Hey, it's the only rejection you've ever had. No.
Oh,
don't. I'm sorry. That was my fault. Right? That was completely my fault.
Go home, Peter.
No, I was giving you mixed signals, OK? And what kind of selfish scumbag does that to his mate?
Please, just, you're forgiven, just go.
No, I've let you down twice today. Carla, look at me. We can get past this. I know we can.
This isn't embarrassing, is it?
You know, friendship is underrated.
Oh, please. I have trotted out that I don't want to lose your friendship so many times.
But I don't. I really don't want to lose yours.
Oh, I can see what's in it for you. Quick ego boost from an old soak.
Former soak.
Then home to Leanne for the real thing. Hey, I'll be the foreplay without the touching.
Oh, come on. Don't say that.
Oh, look. Jean is out the bottle, Peter. Every time I look at you, we're both going to know I fancy you. This is one very doomed friendship.
No, look, hey, we've both got demons. We can help each other, okay? And your feelings for me, they'll fade, especially when you get to know me properly.
You better watch yourself.
So no mixed signals, no awkwardness, just good, honest support, okay? What do you say?
To the crumbs off the table.
You're a twisted beggar, you.